Hi, what's up?
Hello guys, and welcome to another video about game development. And in this video, we will be talking a little bit about how to make a good jump mechanics for your platformer game. We will not talk about how to do this in code, we will just be talking about how to improve your jump mechanics theoretically. And if you want me to do another practical video about this, please let me know in the comments. So, when you are making a platformer game, there is a lot of movement mechanics that you need to make them feel good and enjoyable to play, and also easy for the player to learn but hard for him to master. This balance is what makes your game feel challenging and yet satisfying to play. And one of the most important move mechanics in a platformer game is the jump, since it is the movement that will allow the player to jump from a platform to another. And every game has its own unique movements, including the jump. Every game should have a jump that is perfect for its level design. For example, you can't play Hollow Knight using Super Mario's movement, because simply Mario was not made to explore Hollow Knight's world. So yeah, every game must have its unique jump based on its world or level design. However, there are some rules every game, or at least every modern game, has to respect in order to make the most perfect jump mechanic possible. So the jump is essentially pushing the player up to a certain height, and then it will fall back because, you know, gravity. So we have some variables that we should consider. Some of them are causing others. The first thing is the push power of the jump. Second, the amount of time that the player needs to reach its maximum height, and also the maximum height itself. The force of the gravity applied to the player, and the duration that the player needs to get back to the ground. All those variables and more are connecting to each other, and all of them are making up the curve of the jump. The curve is representing the shape and the feel of your jump. Tweaking those variables will change the shape of the curve, and therefore it will change the overall form of the jump. Every game, of course, has its own unique jump curve. Super Meat Boy, for example, has a long jump curve, which makes its jump a bit floaty. Unravel game has a short jump and not much of a hang time. Ori, on the other hand, has a medium jump curve that can be taller if you press the jump button much longer. So every game has a unique jump that can fit its level design and make the character feel good and satisfying to play. So when you are making a platformer game, what can we do to make a perfect jump for our character? Well, the answer of that may take hours, and because this is a short video, I'm gonna mention a few important things that I think you should consider when you are making a jump for your character. First, avoid being floaty. If your character is taking too much time to get to the maximum height, or hanging in the air more than it should be, or moving a lot while being in mid-air, or anything like that will make your jump feels weird or floaty, and that is something you should always avoid. And that doesn't mean you should make your jump tight or quick more than your character needs, but find something in the middle ground, something that will fit your game, and of course all of that with considering your level design, because in way or another your level design will affect your controls and movement properties. Second, considering other movements when you are making your jump mechanics. Of course, your platformer game will have more than just jump. Walking, running, dashing, bashing, climbing, attacking, and much more. And the jump of your character will be affected when one of those movements are being performed. Therefore, you should consider when or where you have to tweak your jump properties according to the current preferred movement. And also, other movements will be affected by the jump. Should you allow the player to jump when he is dashing? Does the running affect your jump power? Will the damage of an attack increase while doing a jump? All of these kind of questions must be answered when you are making a jump for the character. And of course, that is true for every movement in the game. Protect the players from themselves. You should always protect the player from his mistakes. In other words, when the player dies, for example, he must admit that it was his fault and not yours as the developer of the game. And it is your responsibility to make him see his mistakes so he will not blame the game for unresponsive controls. And in order to do this, you should protect him from any mistakes that he can't see or he can't control as a human being. For example, in this level here, the player is trying to reach the goal, but he is dying because he keeps hitting the spikes. You may say that he is dead because he didn't press the jump button so he can jump. But as you can see, he did press the jump button just 4 or 5 frames before hitting the ground. But from the player's perspective, he did press the jump button in the correct time, but the game didn't respond for him, and he died because of that. And that's what I mean by you should protect the player from the mistakes that he can't see or he can't control. So how we can fix this? Well, when this happens, the game should remember that the user has pressed the jump button just 4 or 3 frames earlier before landing. And therefore, the game must execute the jump as soon as the player touches the ground. And if we apply those mechanics correctly, you can see that the jump control became more responsive and accurate than before, and it will give the player more satisfaction when he is jumping or moving in our level. There are other similar things that you should pay attention to as well, like allowing the player to jump even after leaving a platform for a couple of frames. This will also make your game feel more responsive and fun to play, and it will not make the player feel like the game is punishing him for no reason. Now, maybe a lot of you will be like, are you telling us to make our games easy? I mean, where is the challenge? After all, this is a platformer game, it's supposed to be challenging. Well, easy controls does not equal easy game. Easy and responsive controls are a must in every platformer game or any game in general. But making the game hard or easy is up to other things other than the controls, like level design. So making the controls easy will not make your game the same, and that's something you should consider, at least in my opinion. So yeah, I think that's it for this video. Making the perfect jump for your game is a huge topic, and this video is the brief version of it that I hope you like and find it useful. And before I go, I highly recommend watching this video, Math for Game Programmers Building Better Jump from GDC. It is a really useful video about how to perform better jumps on the programming side. Check that out, you will find it very useful. So that's it for now, thanks for watching and see you later.